last chapter ended on a cliffhanger of a panel where Ushijima had just blasted off a strong spike towards Hinata. This chapter begins with Hinata putting his hands in the way of the cannonball and bumping it up the air. People are shocked that he could receive that at all, and some are, well, not very much amused. But you could tell this was difficult for Hinata. As the ball went back to the Adler's court, Ushijima demanded that the ball be sent back to him. Kageyama had no choice but to obey, and gathering all his hate and zeroing in on Hinata, Ushijima takes off with just a single goal that he also had 5 years ago: to crush Hinata. Hinata feels the intensity and reminds himself not to freak out and zones in back to his beach training. He sees Ushijima about to spike the ball and gathers his footing. As he sees the cannonball approaching towards him, he bends a little bit and seamlessly bumps the ball up the air. Every single one who knows what happened just lost their goddamn minds. Sakusa, meanwhile, just showed a mild discomfort at the notion that a little shrimp was able to receive a powerful spike off his BFF. Coach Uka then reviews Hinata's plays from the entire match and recalls that not only Hinata is thinking one step ahead while receiving the ball, his positioning, his ball control, and his balance have all massively improved. He and Daichi both note that Hinata, while digging in, never bends a knee, no matter how much the situation demands it. We've seen this in the entire match so far. Hinata's athletic abilities have been in full demonstration. His flexibility and his balance have been the unsung heroes so far. But it's not just about his physical abilities. He has also grown much smarter and intelligent since the last time we saw him playing indoors. His tactical know-how of the game as well as his preparation has also gone through the roof. All this has resulted in making Hinata the kind of player who is able to seamlessly receive an ultra-powerful spike of a cannon from a player like Ushijima, who we know left no stone unturned in order to beat him. His face after Hinata picked up his first spike was of annoyance and possibly of someone who still dismissed Hinata as someone who is below his level. However, after the second time Hinata picked up his spike, Ushijima couldn't help but let out a smile while still being frustrated. This is the same person who completely dominated Hinata the first time they played an official match. Hinata was in no position to beat Ushijima one-on-one 5 years ago. The fact that it is no longer true is a big freaking deal. During the 5 years, Ushijima has also grown and trained, and despite this, the Hinata that we know now can hold his own against a cannon like Ushijima is just a mind-blowing fact. Talk about the character growth. You know that if Nishinoya was around, he would have complimented Hinata for his feat right now. The fact that people thought that the ball just landed on Hinata by chance and did not realize that Hinata brilliantly used his entire body to defend just goes on to show how much Hinata has grown. And just look at this panel. Hinata is properly bending backwards while his knees stay perpendicular to the ground. His near-perfect form here is just so masterful, and the fact that he is able to stand up right after this and not fall is just hype. The chapter ended with Hinata making an approach towards the net. I am so hoping Hinata spikes next chapter and is able to show some of his mid-air battling skills as well. Regardless, I think we can all agree with the fact that Hinata is now a monster when it comes to battling it out on the court. He has the skills to be a great decoy and now has proved that he can defend against the most powerful of the strikers. This match, and more specifically this play, has acted like a reset point in the ways of how the big powerful players who have already proved themselves to be the monsters now see Hinata. He has gone big length in establishing himself as a fantastic player. Keep in mind, this is only the first match Hinata has played with the Jackals in an official capacity, and he's not yet a regular on the lineup. Just as how the world noticed Kageyama back in the high school days during his first nationals, the world is about to notice Shoyo Hinata. By the way, I think Shirabo is still eating the salt he took while playing against Karasuno 5 years ago. Just look at how badly he wanted Ushijima to crush Hinata. I so wanted to see his expression after Hinata just denied Ushijima all the glory. What did you guys think about this chapter? Let me know and make sure to like and comment as a tribute to the YouTube algorithm. Also join my Discord server, follow me on Twitter, and subscribe to the newly formed Reddit called HiQ Folks. You guys take care and I will see you all later.